A reading from the devotional, Holding God's Hand. Rock Solid Advice. A testimony by Mary Lou Carney. Praise be to the God and Father of our Lord Jesus Christ, who has blessed us in the heavenly realms with every spiritual blessing in Christ. Ephesians 1, 3. This summer has been eventful for my family. We've welcomed new babies. We've had cookouts and blown a million bubbles, mostly at 2-year-old Isabel Grace's request. We've watched grandson Mace blow out one candle on his birthday cake and eat way too many ice cream cones. Good times. But some of the events haven't been joyful or welcome. My mother-in-law, Opal, was diagnosed with cancer. She spent the summer undergoing chemo at Vanderbilt Hospital in Nashville, Tennessee. They hoped the treatments would shrink the tumor, but the cancer continues to grow. There have been other family problems too, some physical, some financial, others emotional. I wake each morning and pray for the overwhelming needs of those I love. I've even begun to wonder what new calamity might unfold. Which is why the sunflowers were a welcome surprise. Twin stalks rise out of the flower bed near my sunroom. By the time I noticed them, they were knee-high and looked enough unlike a weed not to be pulled. They grew taller, and soon I knew I was going to have sunflowers. As I admired these beauties this morning, I noticed a clump of red geraniums that surrounded a small gray rock, which simply read, Rejoice. Rock solid advice, because in the midst of a trial, there is always God's eternal love and some unexpected blessings. Keep me from being so downcast, Lord, that I forget to look for the flowers lining my pathway. Amen. Faith step. Spend time in a garden today and let your mind concentrate on God's beautiful work.
I come to the garden alone, while the dew is still on the roses, and the voice I hear falling on my ear, the Son of God discloses. And he tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known. I'd stay in the garden with him, though the night around me is falling, but he bids me go through the voice of hope. His voice to me is calling. Tells me I am his own, and the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known. And the joy we share as we tarry there, none other has ever known.